गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, आई एम मिसेस रुशाली चौधरी, लेक्चरर प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अप्लाइड केमिस्ट्री प्रैक्टिकल्स. सब्जेक्ट कोड 222 02. दिस इज फॉर द सिविल एंड मैकेनिकल ग्रुप. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 11, दैट इज अ डिजॉल्व ऑक्सीजन इन अ वॉटर सैम्पल. वॉटर इज कंटेनिंग द डिजॉल्व ऑक्सीजन दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द लिविंग थिंग्स विच इज लिव्ड इन अ water like aquatic plants as well as the fishes. And as the oxygen is dissolved in form of the gaseous, it is difficult to determine. So we are going to determine by the process called as a biochemical oxygen demand. First we are going to treat the water with a MnSO4 to get a precipitate of a oxygen. Then we are going to treat with a H2SO4 and Ki to determine how much oxygen is correspondingly liberated iodine. And we are going to determine liberated iodine present in a water sample. We are not able to determine oxygen as it is. We are converting into the manganese oxide, and manganese oxide is releases the iodine. So we are going to determine how much iodine is liberated. So this is also called as a iodometric titration. This process is also called as a Wrinkler method of BOD determination. Here we are using the burette is filled with 0.025 normal Na2S2O3, that is a sodium thiosulfate. In a conical flask we are going to take a water sample. How we are going to perform the redox titration? Here first we will say the brown color solution is there. Why brown color? As iodine is liberated. So we are going to treat this iodine solution with a thiosulfate till color is become light yellow. After that we are going to add a starch. When we are adding a starch, the solution is become bluish blackish color. This is not the end point. We are going to add a thiosulfate till the solution is become white color or the colorless. We are not directly adding the starch to get an accurate end point. Requirement for this titration is burette, conical flask, beaker, measuring cylinder, stopper bottle, sodium thiosulfate, alkaline iodine azide, and manganese sulfate, water sample, sulfuric acid, starch as a indicator. First we are going to take a 300 ml of BOD stopper bottle. This is a special type of stopper bottle we are using. In this we are going to fill the 300 ml of water. In this water, we are going to put a 2 ml of manganese sulfate below the surface of liquid. Then after, we are going to add 2 ml of alkali iodine azide reagent. And we will keep a stopper on this bottle. We will mix it properly and keep it under dark for the 15 minutes. After that, we are going to add 2 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. When we are adding the sulfuric acid, solution is become clear brown color. Now we are going to take a 100 ml sample from this, and we are going to add sodium thiosulfate till it become light yellow. Then after, we are going to add starch as an indicator. Solution become bluish black. Again we are going to add sodium thiosulfate continuously till the solution is become white color or the colorless. This is called as a procedure. And whatever the reading we are getting, when the color changes blue to colorless, we are going to note down. I am considering three readings, and we are going to take an average as a constant burette reading. See, initially when we are taking a water sample, when we are adding manganese sulfate and alkaline azide, it is going to form a precipitate, and when we are going to add H2SO4, solution is become clear. We are going to keep for 15 minutes and this solution we are using for the titration. Correspondingly, we are going to determine the how much ppm of oxygen is present by using this formula. The question answer related to this already explained during the theory part. Here I written it. Solution turns blue after addition of starch. Why? As the iodine is liberated, that's why solution turns blue. Which color changes at the end point? At the end point, solution it changes color from blue to colorless. Balanced chemical reaction, we already explained in a theoretical background. Here I already written. Question number 3, 4, answers are given. Thank you, class.